Good morning, Transfiguration. Good morning, Transfiguration. For those of you who are visiting, welcome. Thanks for being here bright and early on a good old Father's Day. So starting this week, we are going to be doing something a little bit different during ordinary time. Instead of doing a sung Kyrie, the Kyrie is going to be spoken, led by our deacon. And then after that, we're just going to proceed like normal. But besides that, that's the only fun thing we have. So if I could please have everybody stand, introduce yourself to your neighbor, and ask for a prayer intention for the Mass. Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. Happy Father's Day to the fathers among us, all of us who have fathers who are not in the room, or those who are with the Lord. We wish everyone a happy Father's Day. Let us now turn our attention to the lyrics of the opening song and sing together 10,000 Reasons.
Worship your holy name. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. The Lord be with you.
With your spirit.
Any fathers get breakfast already in bed? What did you say? Make it quick. You do know you're out of bed already, right? As we gather this day, let's take a moment to see God's abundant mercy and love.
Lord Jesus, you came to gather the nations into the peace of God's kingdom. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you came in word and sacrament to strengthen us in holiness. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you will come in glory with salvation for your people. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us of our sins, and bring us into everlasting life.
Amen.
O God, strength of those who hope in you, graciously hear our pleas. And since without you mortal frailty can do nothing, grant us always the help of your grace, that in following your command we may please you by our resolve and deeds. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Ezekiel. Thus says the Lord God, I too will take from the crest of the cedar, from its topmost branches, tear off a tender shoot and plant it on a high and lofty mountain. On the mountain heights of Israel, I will plant it. It shall put forth branches and bear fruit and become a majestic cedar. Birds of every kind shall dwell beneath it, every winged thing in the shade of its boughs. And all the trees of the field shall know that I, the Lord, bring low the high tree, lift high the lowly tree, wither up the green tree, and make the withered tree bloom. As I, the Lord, have spoken, so will I do. The word of the Lord.
Lord, it is good. Lord, it is good to give thanks to you. Lord, it is good. Lord, it is good to give thanks to you. It is good to give thanks to the Lord. To sing praise to your name most high. To proclaim kindness at dawn. Throughout the night.
Lord, it is good. Lord, it is good to give thanks to you.
Just one shall flourish like the palm tree, like a cedar of Lebanon shall he grow. That are planted in the house of the Lord shall flourish in the courts of our God.
Lord, it is good. Lord, it is good to give thanks to you.
They shall bear fruit even in old age. And sturdy shall they be, declaring how just is the Lord, my rock in whom there is no wrong.
A reading from the second letter of St. Paul to Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, we are always courageous. Although we know that while we are at home in the body, we are away from the Lord. For we walk by faith, not by sight. Yet we are courageous, and we would rather leave the body and go home to the Lord. Therefore, we aspire to please him, whether we are at home or away, for we must all appear before the judgment seat of Christ, so that each may receive recompense according to what he did in the body, whether good or evil. The word of the Lord.
Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. Praise Jesus said to the crowds, "This is how it is with the kingdom of God. It is as if a man were to scatter seed on the land and would sleep and rise night and day, and through it all, the seed would sprout and grow. He knows not how. Of its own accord, the land yields fruit, first the blade, then the ear, then the full grain in the ear. And when the grain is ripe, he yields the sickle at once, for the harvest has come." He said, "To what shall we compare the kingdom of God? Or what parable can we use for it? It is like a mustard seed. When it is sown into the ground, it is the smallest of all seeds on the earth. But once it is sown, it springs up and becomes the largest of plants and puts forth large branches so that the birds of the sky can dwell in its shade." With many such parables, he spoke the word to them as they were able to understand it. Without parables, he did not speak to them, but to his own disciples, he explained everything in private. The Gospel of the Lord.
Before my mom and dad were dating, my dad had met another woman who had two children. And he said to her, "So how many other kids would you like to have?" And she said, "I'm done." And he said, "So are we." He walked away from that relationship because he wanted a larger family. And he got it. Six of us. I looked at my life and my father, and he gave everything. He worked two jobs full-time to provide for the six kids and my mom, to allow her to stay home from work. Never complained. Was as present as he possibly could be. My dad worked days, afternoons, and nights every week. When he wasn't working days, he was working his second job. He taught me, all of us, a great work ethic. He gave us an understanding of what it meant to do what you needed to do. At a young age, I went to my father asking for a couple dollars, which was customary. You know, once in a while, they act of a couple bucks, sure. And at one point, I think I was 12, he said, "How old are you?" 12. Said, "You can get a job." What happened to the $2 exchange? It was fine. Started a lawn business, ultimately had a paper route, worked in a restaurant, dug graves in the seminary, cut grass, worked in the post office at school, did what needed to do, to be done. And I'm so very thankful for that. Some would say today that my dad was an absentee father because he was never really around. Some could say that. But my dad needed to do what he needed to do to provide for sustenance for our family. It wasn't luxury living at all. My dad attempted to repair his cars, buy used tires, and various other sundry things to make sure that we had what we needed. There was no Disney cruises. It was often vacations at the state park. We grew up with what we needed to have, not what so we wanted to have. In today's gospel, we hear about this farming experience. This is how it is with the kingdom of God, as if where a man would scatter the seed in the ground, would sleep and rise night and day, and through it all the seed would sprout and grow. He knows not how. I grew up in Indiana. Farming is not like that. It's not as if a farmer just goes out and throws out the seed and waits till harvest time and then gets the harvest. It's work. If you're a gardener, it's work dealing with various sundry attacking animals on the garden and the flowers. You have to be vigilant, cultivate. It's the same with being a parent. It's work, right? And sometimes you wonder at a certain age when they're teenagers why you started it. It's work to cultivate, to nourish, to be present to those entrusted to your care. We need parents who are willing to work. And at times you wonder, what happens? You know, some parents have met over my years of priesthood that have beaten themselves up their whole life because one of their children didn't quite get it together. They grew up in the same household with the same set of parents, the same value system, and they just didn't get it together. And so they beat themselves up. As much work as a parent puts into a child, there has to be the response of that child. And some kids just don't get it together, at least in the time frame that we expect it to happen. But you don't stop being parent. You continue to nourish and love those entrusted to you. In our society today, things are much different than they were when perhaps we were younger. The world is different. The temptations and situations that our children encounter are different and constant. And many of us who are older look at the new generation coming forward and make all kinds of comments and concerned comments about what the future may hold. And by the way, you know, some of the younger generation looks at our present generation and has concerned comments as well. We're not always the best examples. And many of us complain, comment, yell at the television. Yet what are we doing to make a difference? There are many children out there that are in need of good, stable examples of what it means to be an adult for various and sundry reasons. What are we doing to help that? I'll tell you a story, true story. When I was a pastor for 5.5 years at an African-American black parish, I dealt with many children who had no father, other than the biological one that helped produce them. They were abandoned, alone. Single mothers was a common story in the parish. And I never realized it until I left that I had become a father figure to many of those children. When I left, I came to understand that I was yet another male figure that had left them. It was very difficult. And some of those kids are still in contact with me. But I was yet another male that left them. Our world needs good examples of men who stand for the good and reflect the presence of Christ. Whether it be in your own family, if your kids are already grown up, perhaps you look at other options to help be that example to many kids who are in need. That's how we make a difference in our society. We don't do so because we simply yell at the television or comment at some blog that we listen to or some news report. Begin to say, what can I do to help make a difference? What example can I offer to those in my midst that God places most likely right in front of me? It's not simply throwing the seeds out and hoping that everything comes together. It takes work. Example. And a strong Christian foundation. I'm thankful for the many men in my life that have shown that to me. Good priests, my father, and other such men who have challenged me in what it means to be a good and faithful person. Our kids are in desperate need, not just because of perhaps an absentee father. They just need good examples, because what they experience oftentimes is not, whether it be at home or on the internet or in the various media sources that are constantly being put in front of them. This Father's Day, we are called to give thanks to those men who have offered that good example. Not perfect. There are no perfect dads or granddads or uncles. But there are good men who strive to do what is right. And there are others who have failed in that responsibility given to them. We are called to offer forgiveness to those men who have failed. We also can give thanks to the many men who have answered the call to be good and faithful servants to those entrusted to them. This Father's Day, an opportunity not just to prepare breakfast for the men in bed, not just an opportunity for us to be nice to them, but to truly give thanks. The sad part is, I think many Father's Day experiences, my father's always shortchanged. My mother always let us know exactly what she wanted done for Father's Day. My dad said nothing. In many ways, my dad got nothing. At Christmas and various other opportunities, and I think my dad wasn't alone. I think many times men are just simply forgotten on Father's Day. Don't let that happen. Whether it be your father, your grandfather, uncles, or other men who have truly shown that example of goodness and Christian life, it's work. May be willing to put the work in, be those examples of goodness to others, and to give thanks for those that have done that for us. And let us now profess our faith. I let us now offer our prayers to God, our Almighty Father.
Our response is, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the church may continue to grow in holiness as she works to build God's kingdom here on earth. In faith we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That peace and justice will reign among the nations of the earth. In faith we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who work the land will have life-giving rain and abundant harvests. In faith we pray. That this faith community may be blessed with the fruits of the Spirit in our work and ministry. In faith we pray. That fathers will be supported by their communities and blessed by God for the love and care they give to their families. In faith we pray. That the sick and suffering, particularly Father Fernando, be raised in spirit and comforted by our care and concern. In faith we pray. For the repose of the souls of Marvin and Jean Barnes, for whom this Mass is offered, in faith we pray. That the souls of the faithfully departed may find eternal peace in God's presence, especially Maldiz Valando de Paz, Sonia Borgia, and Frederick McDowell. In faith we pray. For your own intentions held in silence of your heart, and those of your sisters and brothers for whom you shared at the beginning of Mass.
Heavenly Father, we turn to you this day and always. The prayers we have offered in our hearts, spoken aloud this day, asked of us by others, may our hearts truly be open to the call you have set before us. We ask all these prayers through Christ our Lord. Amen.
As our gifts are gathered and prepared, let us sing together Good, Good Father, found in the worship aid.
Yeah.
sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all of his holy church.
O God, who in the offering is presented here, provide for the twofold needs of human nature, nourishing us with food and renewing us with your sacrament. Grant, we pray, that the sustenance they provide may not fail us in body or spirit, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts, and let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Holy Father, Lord of heaven and earth, through Christ our Lord, for by your word you created the world. You govern all things in harmony. You gave us the same word made flesh as mediator, and he has spoken your word to us and called us to follow him. He is the way that leads us to you, the truth that sets us free, the life that fills us with gladness. Through your Son you gather men and women whom you made for the glory of your name into one family, redeemed by the blood of the cross and signed with the seal of the Spirit. Therefore, now and for ages unending, with all the angels we proclaim your glory as a joyful celebration we acclaim. Holy, glorified, O God, who loved the human race, who always walk with us on the journey of life. Blessed indeed is your Son, present in our midst when we are gathered by his love, and when as once disciples, so now for us, he opens the scriptures and breaks the bread. Therefore, Father most merciful, we ask you to send forth your Holy Spirit to sanctify these gifts of bread and wine, that they become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, on the night of the Last Supper, he took bread and said the blessing, broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and gave you thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Mystery of faith. Therefore, Holy Father, as we celebrate the memorial of Christ, your Son, our Savior, whom you led through his passion and death on the cross to the glory of the resurrection, and whom you have seated at your right hand, we proclaim the work of your love until he comes again. We offer you the bread of life and the chalice of blessing. Look with favor on the oblation of your church, in which we show forth the paschal sacrifice of Christ, that has been handed on to us. Grant that by the power of the Spirit of your love, we may be counted now until the day of eternity among the members of your Son, in whose body and blood we have communion. By our partaking of this mystery, Almighty Father, give us life through your Spirit. Grant that we may be conformed to the image of your Son and confirm us in the bond of communion, together with Francis, our Pope, Gregory John, our Archbishop, his assistant bishops, the clergy, religious, and with your entire people. Grant that the faithful of the Church, looking into the signs of the times by the light of faith, may constantly devote themselves to the service of the gospel. Keep us attentive to the needs of all that share in their grief and pain, their joy and hope. We may faithfully bring them the good news of salvation and go forward with them along the way of your kingdom. Remember our sisters and brothers who have fallen asleep in the hope and the peace of your Christ, and all the dead whose faith you alone have known. Admit them to rejoice in the light of your face, and in the resurrection give them the fullness of life. Grant also to us, when our earthly pilgrimage is done, that we may come to an eternal dwelling place and live with you forever, there in communion with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Saint Joseph, her spouse, the apostles, the martyrs, with all the saints, we shall praise and exalt you through Jesus Christ, your Son. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. We pray as Christ taught us. Our deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that with the help of your mercy we'll always be free from sin, safe from all distress, as we wait the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always."
Now let us offer each other a sign of Christ's peace. Thank you.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Come forward to receive Holy Communion. Let us sing together. We remember, we believe.
Say what love the Father has.
As this reception of Holy Communion, O Lord, foreshadows the union of the faithful in you, so may it bring about unity in your church through Christ our Lord. Just a couple of announcements. Offices are closed on Wednesday in observance of Juneteenth. Please register for our great journey and consider being a small group leader, food crew, or a building reception. Please pick up a QR code and see the sign-up opportunities in the narthex. Before I give the Father's Day blessing, there'll be some changes in reference to my ability to be here. I'll be spending more time taking care of Father Fernando starting today. So I'll be doing a lot of my stuff here remotely, and be some visiting clergy that will be coming in to help out with liturgies. So I thank you for your prayers and patience and understanding with that situation. Fathers, grandfathers, uncles, those who are fatherly, please come forward for your blessing. You're going to turn and you're going to face the people. And let's extend our hands in blessing over them. Good and gracious God, we ask your abundant blessings upon these men who have accepted and strive to live out the fatherly example to those entrusted to them. Give them guidance. May their hearts truly be open to your presence. And may they reflect your love in how they live their lives. Give them patience and understanding, wisdom. May truly be their guide in all things and in all ways. May they truly strive to live out what it means to be father and to be fatherly in their lives. Strengthen them in their courage and their witness. And we ask these blessings, Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. And we give you thanks. The Lord be with you.
With your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. And the Mass is ended. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord and each other.
Thanks be to God.
mountains to the valleys.